It has now almost been 3 years since the school strike started, and since then millions of more children have joined the fight, fighting for a safe future and a safe present. Children are the ones who will be most impacted by this crisis and the ones who will suffer the most from its consequences. There have been many millions of people, especially young people, mobilized. We need to raise awareness, and we need to create a mass mobilization of people from all over the world. That is the only way that we can win, and that we are gonna take action and treat the crisis like a crisis.
The subject of climate change is very personal to me. In fact, it's more than a subject. I live climate change. I come from an agriculture-based society. However, if the weather continues like this, it could lead to a serious food crisis in my community. Young people are the world's most precious natural resource. I continue to call on policymakers and decision makers to include us in all developmental aspects that have to do with our future, because nothing for us without us.
I actually started my activities at an early age, thinking about the rights of the children in my village. The people here have to fight with various disasters to survive. I believe youth play an important role in the present and future world. We are agents of change, and it's our time to take climate action. We also need greater investment in important services in countries like Bangladesh to make us more resilient to climate change.
I have such vivid memories of doing my homework by the candlelight as typhoons raged outside, wiping out electricity. My country is one of the most vulnerable countries in the world to the climate crisis, yet we only contribute less than 0.4% to global carbon dioxide emissions. Far too long, the voices from the global south or the most affected areas have been ignored by those in power, and that has to change. And so we're coming together as a global youth movement that continues to grow and to unite to amplify the voices most marginalized. And together, we won't stop demanding governments and decision makers for urgent and bold action, because we refuse to compromise on our lives.
And we must remember that children are not just the victims of this crisis, but we're also the solution. We need to listen to children.